Hello, Internet. Rumbutt here. And the time has come. Let's go place Lothric's cinders upon his throne.
Undeserving of the honor. Speak with the Firekeeper. I took the mantle of Lord of Cinder of mine own volition. I speak these words with pride. Choose thy fate alone. Seize it with thine own hands. All the more should thy fate entail such foul betrayal.
All right. The time has come. Let's speak with the Firekeeper.
The five lords sit their five thrones. All thanks to thee, most worthy of lords. Ashen One, with the lords as thy witness, bend thy knee afore the bonfire's coiled sword, and let the Lord's embers acknowledge thee as their true heir, a true lord, fit to link the fire. Farewell, Ashen One. Mayst thou thy peace discover.
All right. Time to kneel at the bonfire.
Noble Lords of Cinder, the fire fades. And the lords go without thrones. Surrender your fires to the true heir. Let him grant death to the old gods of Lordran, deliverers of the first flame.
I And we've arrived someplace that looks very familiar, but very different. The thrones remain, but there's no light, no flame, no cinders. The fires that seem to be within the stone of the thrones have even gone out. And the shrine is decrepit and ruined. Pillars broken. All paths but the path leading out destroyed. Blocked with rubble and debris. There's only one way to go. Cemetery of Ash has disappeared. Lothric has crumbled in on itself. And this great tree stands out there. And we see a bonfire here, and our first instinct, of course, is to light it. Well, let's wait for a moment. Let's look around. So we see this great tree-like structure here. Out there is just mountains. Lothric has shifted because I recall it being over there. No, it hasn't. Not that much. But now, because this area here has collapsed, right, we can see this. If we look down there, I don't know. Very interesting. But this bonfire here is not a bonfire, really. It says proceed to the first flame, so let's do it. So here we are at the kiln of the first flame. We're actually within sight of where we just were. I'm gonna light this bonfire. Rest at it really quick. The bonfire for the kiln. We can see that this is a massive tree that's risen up. And there's this ash blast. And then over there we can see Firelink. We can see Firelink from here. There's Firelink Shrine. That's where the Cemetery of Ash and parts of Lothric would have been. But they've now all collapsed. The towers around Firelink are gone, and only the center of the shrine remains. This is what remains of Lothric. We look over here. Don't know if we can see anything off in this direction. But over that way is where most of the game should have taken place. However, we can't really see. Anyway. We're gonna go ahead and come up this way. I heard a summon sign. Who can I summon for? Oh! We can summon the Pale Shade of Londor. Interesting. Is there anyone else we can summon? Oh, I heard another one. Where is it? We can summon Yuria for this battle. And make no mistake, this is a battle. Sword version. Yep. By the grab. And I die. So this boss is very much similar to, and thematically speaking, it makes perfect sense. Very similar to fighting an amalgamation of a bunch of different builds by a bunch of different players. And thematically it makes sense because it's supposed to be everyone who linked the fire, basically. Alright, round two. Dead. Didn't even get a chance to use Estus. Fortunately, there's no boss run or anything like that, just beautiful scenery to take in on your way up to the first flame. Dodge. curved sword. Sword I have trouble with. Damn it, got hit by Wrath of the Gods. Hit by the throne. And the spinny spin. Dodged a little bit too late. Sorcery. You got the buff off. Damn it! Regular sword. Damn it! Sorcery. He's got the buff up. Right? Run! Curved sword. Fuck. Curved sword with the fucking thing? No. No. Sorry, but no. Back off, back off, back off! Heels. Only took a little bit of lightning damage from that. Thanks, Faith. And I'm dead. Need to do more damage faster in the first phase. You know what? I'm gonna start throwing crossbow bolts. Well, that's interesting. Yeah, when I'm up against the, the ones that I can't get close to because I suck at them, I'll use the crossbow. Damn it. Oh shit. Damn it. Too early. Damn it. All right, let's see. I guess great heal. Yeah. And then that's not really helping us, so we'll throw the simple shield on. Or yeah, okay. Try this setup. Do flame. Damn it. Always dodge that too early. Do the jump. Come on, Gwen. Damn it. Almost had him. One more shot. I'm going to give it one more try, and then I'm going to take a break and get back to it. Stuck in the heel chain is no good. Damn it, too late. There's only one thing to do when a boss is kicking your ass like this, and it's to take a quick break and, you know, get some food, drink some water, stuff like that. So that's what I'm gonna do. Alright, so took a little break, came back, made some adjustments to my equipment, so my stone parma is now blessed. My target shield is still simple, and hopefully with those regens, because I have them both on, hopefully with those regens I'll be able to make something happen. So now I have my simple shield on. To get mana regen, to get my mana back. Got too early. Yeah, Bad heal. Whatever. Use the Estus Flask. Shit. Yeah, I don't expect to succeed this time. Woo! That second attack saved me. Shit. Put my simple shield back on to get regen. Yeah, he's got his buff up now. That's not good. Damn it, not too early. Not enough time. Trying to get too fancy, that's my problem here. That was close. shit. Bad heal. Damn it. Dodged the wrong time. Last Estus. Shit! Setup worked, and I got the soul of the lords. Okay, hold on. Need to turn the HUD off because I have this dumb shield effect on. Woo! All right. Yeah, sometimes when you hit a wall, you just need to take a few minutes. Oh, my hands are tingly. Sometimes when you hit a wall, you just need to take a few minutes and recalibrate yourself. Let yourself calm down. Step away for a few minutes. And then come back and adjust your setup and put some really dumb shit on. Like, I don't think the regen shields really help me that much. so we can look around. I'm trying to look around and see if we can see any scenery from the rest of the game. Other than, you know, the ruined Lothric. This over here is pretty interesting. What the... This wall... I'm pretty sure this wall is just to prevent us from seeing the rest of the game world. Probably. But yeah, it's pretty cool. Pretty cool. Now. Oh man, and this arena is so cool. So actually now, I totally forgot to talk about something. But I want to talk about, since we got a little bit of time, I want to talk about how the... So we know from both interviews and from the information that we've gathered throughout the game that the Unkindled are those who failed to become Lords of Cinder, right? And the Lords of Cinder are... They're people who previously linked the fire. Now, Ludlith tells us that the five Lords of Cinder are meant to be kindling for the linking of the first flame. Right? They're meant to be kindling for the linking of the first flame in a reenactment of the first linking of the fire. So here's the thing. They're kindling for linking of the fire. But when you're making a fire, there are three different things that you have. You have tinder, which is like really like dry grass or wood shavings that picks up a spark really easily but burns out super quick, right? And then you have fuel, that's like the big logs that are actually what the fire's burning for a long sustained period of time. The kindling is what's in between that. It's like sticks. Sticks that will catch fire more easily than the fuel and will let the fire build up more. Right? They'll catch fire from the tinder. They won't catch fire as easily as the tinder, but they'll catch it far easier than the fuel will. And the kindling takes the fire from the tinder and expands it and will burn for longer than the tinder will and gives the flames enough time and chance to expand enough to actually light the fuel on fire. So when they're talking about the Lords of Cinder, the five Lords of Cinder in their thrones being kindling for the linking of the first flame, they're talking about the Lords of Cinder can't link the flame anymore. They've already used their power. They've already been fuel for the fire when they linked the fire. They're not linking the fire. They're kindling for you, the unkindled. Only once you come to the kiln of the first flame, you're no longer unkindled because you have the, you know, the flames and the power from the previous Lords of Cinder, right? So that's what I think is going on. Now, getting back to this, you'll notice there's a summon sign here, and of course the fire. Now, if you don't give the eyes of the Firekeeper to the Firekeeper, that summon sign will not appear. That is the Firekeeper's summon sign, and that is the option to get one of the endings. Now, if you don't do all the Dark Sigil stuff, then when you link the fire, you'll link the fire. But regardless, when you get to this point in the game, you have a choice between either... If you gave the eyes to the Firekeeper, you have the choice between either hitting the summon sign and summoning the Firekeeper and letting the fire die, or linking the fire. Now, linking the fire will do one of two things, depending on whether or not you have the Dark Sigil. Or the Dark Sigils, the 8 Dark Sigils, full Dark Sigils. I haven't seen what happens when you do this yet, so let's link the first flame. Well, that was interesting. Okay, I've seen two of the endings now. This video is not going to come out for a while. I'm about, at this point, I'm maybe 2.5 weeks ahead of my release schedule in terms of what I'm playing. So I've only seen two of the endings at this point. There are four, technically speaking. So I'll be playing through to get footage of the other two that I haven't seen in between now and when this video is going to get released. And hopefully tomorrow, as of you watching this or me releasing this, as of me releasing this or you watching this, tomorrow I will be releasing a video with the other three endings, with footage from the other three endings. One of them from my first playthrough, and then two from a couple of playthroughs that I'm going to do in a moment. But damn, is that... That's... Yeah. Alright. That was interesting. That was interesting. Now, I will say that the vanilla Link the Fire ending, which I have seen, I just haven't gotten, is super boring. It's super boring. You link the fire, you catch fire, you kneel down, and then the game, it goes to the credits. The other ending that I've seen, which is the Let the Fire Die ending, is very interesting when you summon the Fire Keeper, and there's a special thing that you can do in that ending that will change it, which I haven't done yet, which I'm going to be doing, and appreciate the fact that I'm going to be doing it, because goddamn do I not want to do what you have to do to get that ending. But I'm going to do it for the sake of seeing it myself, but also showing it to you. So, you know, there you go. I came into this playthrough knowing what I'd have to do to Henri to get this ending, and I really didn't want to do it. Really didn't want to do it. But I had to do it to get this ending, so, you know. All in the name of completion, I suppose. So, here we have the credits, and their awesome, the awesome epilogue song. Man. Ugh. That's a funny thing with bosses, like, you do all this fancy shit sometimes to beat the boss, and then in the end it doesn't really make that much of a difference. And then, you know, I suppose it's just like it's like a psychological cushion in your mind telling you, you know, I have this to fall back on. And, but I did definitely pull out all the stops there, jumping in. That, if you don't get caught in that big wombo combo that the Soul Ascender does when it's in Gwyn mode, if you don't get caught in that, that's a perfect opportunity to, you know, heal, buff, or fucking go into your menu and fucking pop an item like an Ember or a fucking Divine Blessing, for fuck's sake. Even though I immediately took hits after I popped those, I still, you know, it still benefited me. I still managed to pull the win out of there somehow. But yeah, that's Dark Souls 3 right there. And man. I love this game. I love this game. It's everything I wanted it to be. And here's the cast and the voice actors all did a fantastic job. All of them. Just amazing. Just great job. Everyone on this list did a great job. As good as the game is, I do have some criticisms of it. I have some criticisms of the linearity of it. But, I mean, they really couldn't... If they wanted you to have the Fire Keeper as a level-up NPC, they had to have you teleport back. They had to have the option to teleport back be there. And, you know... And that's separate from the linearity. The linearity, I feel like it could have split off more in either the Crucifixion Woods, or even though it does split off in the Crucifixion Woods, it doesn't really. Or in Undead Settlement, actually. When I was initially getting, I thought that the undead settlement was where it was going to branch off, and you were going to be able to go to one of three places or something like that. So that's a little bit like, you know. But, yeah. And then as far as, like, the warping, like, they did some of the stuff with, like, the Dark Souls one, sort of, like, go back and get items from people's corpses, but it doesn't really... It doesn't work as well because you don't, like, unless you know it's there, you're not going to walk back through those places. And, you know, I understand why they had to have the warp. They had to have the warp because if they're going to have a level up NPC, like the Firekeeper, who's going to be at a particular location, you have to have the warp from the start of the game. And that kind of gets in the way of other things. Whereas in Dark Souls 1, obviously, you know, you could level up the bonfire, but you'd have to walk back to merchants and whatnot. But I don't think we're ever going to get a situation like Dark Souls 1 again, because that was just, you know, that was a perfect storm of just things coming together. You know, and Dark Souls 1 is great, and it's wonderful, and without Dark Souls 1 and even Dark Souls 2, we wouldn't have Dark Souls 3, and honestly, I think, my personal opinion, having played all of the games except Demon's Souls, I haven't played Demon's Souls, I've seen Demon's Souls, my personal opinion, having played all of the other games, is that Dark Souls 3 is the best one out of all of them. But, you know, that's me. A lot of people are going to disagree, a lot of people are going to say, is there anything? Okay, yeah, it's just there. A lot of people are going to say that Dark Souls 1 is the best, absolutely 100%. A lot of people are going to say Demon's Souls is the best, absolutely 100%. And you know what? That's their opinion, and they're welcome to it, and I'm not going to argue with them, because it's pointless to argue with them. But in my personal opinion, and some people might even say, you know, Dark Souls 2, probably, you know, I mean, there are probably some out there. Some people are probably going to say Bloodborne, and you know, but to me, Dark Souls 3, like I said before, it's like the greatest hits of the Souls series. They really brought together, I feel like they really brought together all of the best things from all of the games, along with some new improvements and some new stuff, and it's fucking fantastic. And you know, there's been a lot of stuff going on the internet about how Dark Souls 3 is the end of the Souls series, but I don't know. I feel like that's some, like, lost in translation. Some press outlet put that out there, and then it just, you know, and then the internet just acts like an echo chamber. I don't know. What Miyazaki has said, what I've read from direct quotes from Hidetaka Miyazaki, who's the director of Dark Souls and the president of From Software, is that Dark Souls 3 is a turning point for the Souls series and for From Software. I have not actually seen any direct quotes where he says that it's the end. Now, if it is the end, right? If it is the end, I'm okay with that, because it's what a fucking end. Holy shit. But I'm not going to jump on the bandwagon in the echo chamber saying, oh, this is the last Souls game, because I don't think they've actually said that. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, if there's a direct quote, don't give me some press, you know, if you send me some press speculation or whatever that doesn't have a direct quote from somebody at From Software or Hidetaka Miyazaki saying Dark Souls 3 is the end of the Souls series, if it's not a direct quote from them, it doesn't change, because everything else has just been speculation on the part of the press, on the part of the community, probably some bad translations here and there, or some, you know, it's, you know, the language barrier can cause some misunderstandings, but, you know, don't come in here and start linking me to all these articles that say Souls is over that don't have a direct quote from someone from the company saying this is, you know, Dark Souls 3 is the end, because that's exactly what I'm talking about. It's just people keep repeating the same thing over and over and over, and eventually that just becomes, you know, the common wisdom and all that. Anyway, I've been blah, 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 blahing over and over and over. I'm going to keep this character in a regular new game so that I can save him for the DLC, which is going to be coming out in fall And then later on, spring of next year as well, we have confirmed windows for each DLC. But yeah, that is Dark Souls 3. It's a fantastic game. I had a blast playing through it the second time. You know, talking to all of you on the internet about, you know, the things I liked and the things I love. And you can look forward, hopefully, to more videos from me about fucking lore, doing some PvP, just doing wild and crazy stuff, maybe. I'll be trying to get those endings, the other endings, released the day after this releases, if at all possible. I should be able to do it, because I've got weeks, and I can breeze through the rest of, you know, if I use summons, I can breeze through the game in a couple of, you know, probably in a day. Probably in a day. I can probably finish the whole game really quick, if I don't hold myself to the, oh no, you can't use summons because that's kind of cheating easy mode. And it's like, dude, if I need to get the footage, I'm going to use some fucking summons. But, I mean, as you saw here, I did summon for the old Demon King, but you know what? I can post up some footage of soloing the old Demon King on my first playthrough, if you don't believe me. I mean, I don't really think that's necessary. I'll probably put up some footage of that along with Wolnir, since I didn't, like, we didn't see any moves of Wolnir. But anyway, I've been going on fucking yap, yap, yap for too long. Thank you, everybody, so much for watching. Please look forward to some more Dark Souls 3 content, maybe some Overwatch content from me in the near future. But once again, thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, you know what to do. Later, Internet.